Hello, welcome to a special criminal investigation on the C64, also known as Chase HQ2. This is a conversion from the coin-op. Now, Chase HQ wasn't converted particularly well to the 64, so let's see if this version is any better. Now, I'm playing this on cartridge, which was in fact the only official release for this game. It was never released on cassette or disc. And to be fair, I would imagine the multi-loads would be quite horrendous on cassette anyway, so it's probably for the best. Now, let's get started. Now, this is developed by Probe, and it's an evolution of the engine that was used in Turbo Outrun. You can see this time that the car itself is a lot smaller than the car in Turbo Outrun, so this maybe adds to the playability a little bit. It also helps that there's more enemy cars on screen at the same time, there's at least two. And there's four lanes on the road, so it's a bit more playable from that point of view. But the road routine itself is fairly similar to the one in Turbo Run. Oh, blown it already. Unfortunately, the car doesn't handle very well. The cornering is terrible. It's not really. It really feels pretty sluggish. There we go. So now we've got. But to be honest, there's some nice tunnels, and that's quite well done. Best to activate the turbo and just keep battering into the enemy car. There's five levels, I think it's five levels in total, or thereabouts. And on the coin-op version, there's quite a bit of variety in the levels, but unfortunately the 64 version, the levels almost look identical. There's no real feeling of progression. Which is a bit of a shame. It's definitely the biggest flaw in the game, I think. These presentation screens, they're okay. I mean, they could have been better, I think. But I quite like the music. It's quite sort of bouncy. There's only one tune. In game tune doesn't change per level. Oops. I think it's fair to say that this is a lot better than Chase HQ was on the 64. But in terms of gameplay, I think this falls short compared to Turbo Charge on the 64. I think Turbo Charge is a much better game, I think. I think, not just the gameplay, but I think also the graphics and the music are much more polished than Turbocharger. You could argue about the road routine is better. It's down to personal choice, maybe. These graphics. I mean, they're supposed to be crossing a river here, and they're supposed to be waves splashing over the side of the bridge. But well, it just looks the same as the last level, to be honest. And same with the next level. It takes place in sort of caverns and waterfalls. But on the 64, it just looks the same as all the other levels. to be honest, I just don't think the gameplay is really all that great. It doesn't. Okay, the concept is the same as the coin-op, but it just doesn't really play like the coin-op, or I mean, I say that none of the levels look like the coin-op. The gameplay just feels a bit weird. It's okay. I mean, there's certainly a lot worse race games than this on the 64. You know, it's a far cry from Crazy Cars 3, Crazy Cars, or Cisco Heat. I mean, this is obviously quite competent, and it's certainly a playable game. Right. Well, what am I going to give it? It's all right. It's probably. I don't think it's as much fun as a Turbo Outrun, and it's certainly not as, the action is not as good as a Turbo Charge. I need to rate it down for the handling of the car. It's just not fun to control at all. So I'll give it 7 out of 10. I think it's decent enough, but you're probably better playing it. Playing the arcade version or one of the other Konami versions, they're probably a bit more faithful than this version. Okay, that's all for this video.